everyone, I've let the painting dry overnight and I've also been just reflecting on the theme. I said in the last clip that I would listen to some spa music, so this is some lovely Christmas spa music. It's nearly Christmas 2020 as I record this video, and I'm really obviously there's a big piece here that needs some love, and I'm really just really inspired to do a great big the salon owner loves pinks and roses and flowers. So one of my favorite colors at the moment is the, forgive my pronunciation, the quinacridone colors. So I've got some red, I'm going to mix in some white, it makes a really lovely pink, and I'm just going to play. In fact, to show the whole thing of playing, I'm going to just play. I'm just going to sub that, I'm just going to mix on. I'm focusing on the bottom corner. I'm just really going to see where it goes, but I'm really loving the energy of it. And I still want to keep my greys. In fact, I'll probably accent my greys. And I just want it to be a big, juicy, happy painting with a real emphasis. I love Georgia O'Keeffe, who said she wanted to give people, most people don't take time to just look at flowers, and she wanted to get them to look at them really close up. I don't like that green very much, it's a bit too cool. So I'm just, doesn't matter, remember you're playing. It doesn't really matter because you're just playing with colour, right? You can rub it up at any stage. I really like these deeper colours, so I don't want to do too much here. Some light in the centre. Of course, rose is often dark, but sometimes the edges are tinged with light. And then that lovely magenta quinacridone. Might just put it straight in there. Oh, I love that. Look at it. Oh yeah, that's really popping, isn't it? So how about it's just finding the colours that make the soul sing? Oh, I love that. And I don't want to mix it too much, so I think I don't like that dark in there, so I'm going to get rid of that. Like I said earlier, I often struggle with darks. I don't know what it is with me and darks, but I don't really like them. I might get my trusty spray. What I tried to do this time was set up the studio, because so often I'm so impatient that I'm rushing. The other thing I just wanted to show you that I'm using as part of my inspiration is this lovely orchid. So I might throw in some dots soon, because look at all the lovely dots and the heart of yellow and that lovely lime green. Lots of spas have yellows and yummy yellows. chocolatey grey. They just go so beautifully together, don't they? Trying to think how you're going to treat the bottom corners and also just the top corners, but I may just let this one, I might just let it talk to me again, might let it just sit for a while. I'm thinking about the centre here at the moment. So I'll stand back and look at it and I might play with some dots. Some deeper dots. It's fun, isn't it? I think I would use the magenta because that seems to be really the colour of the salon. I just am so in love with this colour. Let's see. Might be a bit damp. I'm just going randomly, really. I was looking at the work of Gustav Klimt, who of course is famous for the Woman in Gold and such a beautiful painting, and there's so many shapes and outlines. I'm not sure. I shouldn't say not sure. One should always be confident when playing. But I might put a bit of yellow. And I feel I might need a bit of light coming through there. Let's just see. Sometimes I struggle to get the lid off. Perhaps it wants me just to dunk my pencil, my pen in here, my inky. the music is guiding me a little bit. It's a lot softer now. What do we need, people? Needs to be a bit darker, that green, so I'm just going to put a little bit of my favourite pink in. Lovely. You can always put a bit of the complementary in. I really love Payne's Grey, so I'm thinking of my painting's moving around. It's really darkening up the corner here. breathing some life into the edges. You know, I struggle with darks, but look, I'm going for it. I like that little pop of James Gray, actually. But I don't want to lose this murkiness either, so I am going to soften that a little bit. Get my trusty spatula. Spray more on the lightness. I'm really loving the violets that are coming through here. It's a little square there for my liking, so I'm going to just soften that. Thank you. that colour up there. So you can see I'm starting to just relax into it now. I'm just playing a little bit, playing some, oh, gotta be careful though, just layering in a few darker corners. And so I'm just going to probably call it a night, because I'm starting to get tired, and then I'll just rush stuff. Sometimes happy accidents can happen when you're tired, but I'm just going to think about the shape. I'm going to do like this green effect with the violets and
thank you.
okay. I think it's a good space for me to finish for tonight. And let's have a look. I think it's really good, just to Leonardo da Vinci once said that it's really good to take some time away from your art and come back refreshed. So that's what I'm going to do. In terms of cleaning my brushes, because I don't want to put all this into the wastewater and pollute the earth, I do tend to just wipe out all my brushes, cleanse them in a bucket, and then I always like to tidy up after a good session. And yeah, begin fresh. So that's what I'm going to do. Making a beautiful grey. Oh, I've got to use this. I like to use the last bits of my paint actually. So let's get this lovely grey in somewhere. Yeah, I'm not really happy with that